Your life literally is as valuable as a summer ant.
Joker's new look in Suicide Squad, Kill the Justice League is the epitome of a mess. Seriously, who thought the timid hipster was a good idea? He looks like a rejected double from Jared Leto's portrayal of Joker. It's like he raided a Gen Z teenager's closet from the early 2010s. The only thing scarier than his appearance is the thought that someone got paid to design that monstrosity. It's like they tried to make him quirky, but ended up with a cringeworthy disaster. The only thing this fucker is killing is my faith in good character design. He changes the game to Suicide Squad. Make me commit suicide. Because honestly, it's starting to seem like better entertainment than this cringe-ass bullshit. I mean, seriously, who the fuck thought it was a brilliant idea to turn one of the most iconic villains into a wannabe gangster reject, looking like a bozo that the real Joker would clown on? It's a total fucking disgrace to the character's legacy. That goddamn face looks like a preschooler got hold of a marker and went to town on his face. And don't even get me started on that suit. He looks like a fucking washed-up pop star who never made it big. Whoever greenlit this shit should be fired immediately. It's a travesty, a total fucking abomination that should never see the light of day. It's worse than any type of parody of the Joker you can think of. I'd rather watch Doug Walker play Melvin, brother of the Joker, on repeat than this pathetic twink. I already know the Suicide Squad will give him shit in the future story, and he'll end up being Harley's bitch the whole time. His look has been through hell and back. He has changed, but not for the better. His new look sucks ass. This looks like an ass crack on a stick, and I hope Suicide Squad, Kill the Justice League flops like a goddamn fish because of it. This fucker got a smile on his face that looks like it's from The Sims. This guy looks like a cross between a homeless man and a drag queen. He is the clown prince of nothing, because no one gives a damn about him anymore. It looks like he got plastic surgery from a Mexican surgeon. If I had just one bullet, I would shoot Joker in his head. Joker would be better off with the old look. Now he looks like a meth addict with a clown fetish. His face is probably greasier than a Cash App scammer. Why is he dressing like a hobo? He should go back to his Arkham outfit. Even that was better than this hot garbage. This Joker looks like a 13-year-old on drugs.
Push the button. Come on, push the button.
Yeah, come on, push the button.
Push the goddamn button.
Push the goddamn button.
You heard what she said.
Bringing the Joker back from the dead just to butcher his character for some multiverse bullshit is a complete disservice to the Arkham canon and spits on the profound impact of his death. The Joker's demise in the Arkham series was a pivotal moment, symbolizing the end of an era and the culmination of the Batman-Joker dynamic. By cheapening his death with a lazy resurrection via multiverse and a half-assed makeover, it diminishes the emotional weight and storytelling integrity of the entire Arkham universe. The Joker's death wasn't just a plot device, it was a thematic conclusion, highlighting the eternal struggle between Batman's sense of justice and the Joker's chaotic madness. Bringing him back in a half-baked, nonsensical way not only undermines the narrative coherence of the Arkham series but also tarnishes the impact of his sacrifice. It's like rewriting Shakespeare to give Hamlet a happy ending. It destroys the essence of the character and the story. The Joker's death was meant to resonate and leave a lasting impression on fans and viewers alike. To cheapen that for the sake of shock value or some convoluted multiverse plot is a slap in the face to both the character and the fans who invested in his story. This resurrection of the Joker for the sake of a gimmicky multiverse twist not only undermines the emotional impact of his death but also dilutes the essence of his character. The Joker is more than just a villain, he is Batman's dark mirror, the embodiment of chaos, and the ultimate test of the Dark Knight's resolve. By bringing him back in a shallow and contrived manner, it reduces him to a mere caricature of his former self. Furthermore, altering the established Arkham canon to shoehorn in this multiverse arc is a lazy and disrespectful move that disregards the careful storytelling and character development that went into building the Arkham universe. The Joker's death was a poignant moment that carried weight and consequences. This resurrection plotline tarnishes the character of the Joker and damages the integrity of the previous game's stories. The Arkham series was known for its deep storytelling, intricate character development, and emotional resonance. By undoing a major event like the Joker's death, it disrupts the narrative flow and coherence of the entire series. It invalidates the sacrifices made, the emotional impact felt, and the thematic significance of the past games. Moreover, retconning such a pivotal moment retroactively diminishes the player's investment in the narrative. Fans who were emotionally affected by the Joker's death now have to grapple with the fact that his demise was not final, eroding the trust and emotional connection they had with the storytelling. It creates a sense of narrative whiplash and undermines the sense of consequence that was meticulously built throughout the previous games. The Joker's death was a culmination of years of storytelling and character development, and to undo it in such a careless manner damages the legacy of the Arkham series and leaves a bitter taste in the mouths of loyal fans. And another thing I can't stop thinking about is the way Harley talks down on Batman. First, I can't help but think it's the writers using her as a soapbox to project whatever personal bullshit went down behind the scenes. And frankly, I don't care to listen to whatever bullshit they attempted to use Harley as a mic for. Take that with you and your boss. Second, this version of Harley and Ivy never once had a relationship in the Arkham universe. They only had two interactions. One brief in Arkham Asylum and another in the Harley Quinn DLC mission in Arkham Knight. Third, Harley talking down to Batman is very hypocritical and pathetic. The writers want us to care for four idiots who caused serious harm to many lives. Yet they dare to act high and might to the heroes who protected the innocent. Hell, the writers don't even understand basic DC Comics lore. They don't even care to make the boss battles interesting. Y'all are gonna have to fight multiple reskins of Brainiac for the next year. I honestly hope the shills that glazed the game look utterly stupid when this game gets canned just like Marvel's Avengers. Hope that revenue was worth you all lying through your teeth. In the end, you screwed your fans, lost money, and tarnish a respectable developer. So congrats new replacement writers of Rocksteady Studios. I now understand how you drove the original team out. Congratulations, you killed a franchise. I hope it was worth it. Fuck you.
Thank you.